for that, sir. Everybody have something to say, but this is my... This is my time. And happiness and peace in this world until he turned my life over fully. God, I will never find peace and happiness until he turned my life over back to God. I had a conversation with this man, the manager. And I go through my problems and then I'm in this business with them. I was sex with a man. Plus, Cara was on the phone. Cara, who is my road manager, she was on the phone and I've been dealing with her a lot. And I said to the man, he said, all of them have problems I want me to deal right now. Said to him, say, no, but I feel, say, yeah, go through this, I'm a feel no way. Because guess what? All I want me to face now is to move me closer to God. Me say, oh, no, feel, say, the problem, me want me to face. Me feel no way about it. Me say, no, feel no way. Because guess what, no man? Me am a calling for my life. Me am a calling for my life, and God, and not for my door, I'm in the answer. If I need an answer, I'm going to say to myself, say, I will never find peace, and I will never be happy, and I start to make duty what God has said to me. And then the conversation from the call, just say, I go stop with this dancehall, and I go step out. Go back to my God. And this time I make a vow. Say, so when me tap, nothing can bring me back. Nothing can bring me back. I don't have money problem. Mind you, I'm going to show you everything on me. I am going to show you everything that you need to know. Because you see, what I have here, my mental health. You see, my mental health and my spirituality, and that alone matter to me. You're not business about money. This world not deserve me. And the Bible says, what does it profit a man to gain the world and lose his soul? You see this manager, named Richard Flores, in my situation, he represents the devil itself. You see, the money, it represents the objects of the world where my soul are trying to hold on to. You see my situation, it represents the choice. But God has given me now to choose where we go from here. You see, everything when it happens, my worries is that if I stop now, how me I go find my food later? How me I go reach us up? How me I go get this? How many days I go pay? But you know what the fight said to me? God is your provider, Shani. Have faith in the Lord, because God. God is your provider. God is your provider. God is your provider. God is your provider. Why you worry? Williamstown Bridge. Just a minute. May God bless. May God bless. May God bless. Do you hear me saying it now? Just a minute. May God bless. May God bless. I'm a faith. I have never lost faith. I have never lost faith in God. I never lose faith in God ever. No matter how much sin before Him. No matter how much sin. My God is forgiving. And no matter what me do in my eyes, He's forgiving. And as long as me have life, He has made it possible for me to come before Him and ask for forgiveness and change my life. And me now go make the situation now. Me now go make because of what's happening now, me make the wrong choice. Now I'm going to make the wrong choice. Now I'm going to make the wrong choice. I decided to share this with them. I decided to share this with them because I have always been transparent. Always. Always been transparent. And to be real to my fans and everybody who supported me. Everybody who has ever supported Shania. I am very grateful. But on this day, I can't live a life of sin no more. Not solely like that. I can't have one foot in or one foot out. Because I walk in this and this when God bless me, now bless me, half a blessing. Mr. Richard Flores, I forgive you. I thank you. Mr. Richard Flores, Richie Flores from Rebel Ace Music. Forgive you, Richard and Amy. Forgive you. I thank you. You know I thank you. When I pray on my hands, God said, carry me closer to you. I said, God, bring me closer to you. And in the depths of my situation, I can see where He has used you. Allowed you to do what you have done and bring you closer to Him. I'm showing everything now. Mr. Richard Flores, Richie Flores, Rebel Ace Music. Managing me without a contract, of course, for the past from December of last year. Right? I opened an LLC and I opened a business account. When I opened those, I asked him to run me the money through the account. So, I have a legit business now. They can use this as a business. This is where we call it as a business. I was so tied up into work, meaning that I was just working, doing shows. I am paid, or the agreement was I would pay Richie 20% for his management consult. And he said to me, I will find. You're going to need a booking agent. I could find a booking agent for you. And he said that I'll try to talk to him to see if he will do 5%, but they usually charge 10%, so I'll ask them if they will. And he came back to me and said, they'll charge you 10%, so that's 20% for him and 10% for my bookings. So that's 30% of whatever performance a promoter will pay me. Right, I started doing bookings. I'ma get so lost in the work, so lost in creating music, so lost in just performing and, you know, doing all of that. When I catch up on everything, I've been working since December of last year. I'm gonna stop work. I'm gonna watch me show and everything. me been out do music, me been out do show like non-stop, no back to back, every weekend, everything. You understand? And I said to him multiple times, I said, hey, the booking agent that used to work for me, he was messing up a lot of stuff. Like, I would simply just ask, you know, for in the first class flight, whatever is asked by the promoters, I'd have a first class flight and I'd just ask for a window seat, because sometimes when we leave the show, them are going to the shows, I'm very tired. Most times, if it's not Jojo or anybody else, I pay to do my hair. I do my hair for myself. You do my hair, can I hear me? Okay. I do my hair for myself and stuff like that, you understand? But I ended up firing the booking agent that he brought on, because he was not doing, you know, he was not working up to my expectations. Even after I asked him to fire the person, he didn't feel the immediate effect. You understand? So first of all, I've been giving clear instructions on certain things, but they're not being carried out. So I somewhat don't have the control that I thought I had. Secondly, now, they reach up to the part where I asked them to stop tech bookings, right? And I said, stop tech bookings, please, I need a break. Ask them to stop tech bookings, I need a break. I need to step back, I mean, need to figure stuff out. My team was not 100%, it's not solid, so it's hard to put everything in when we need to do that. You understand? I'm saying multiple times, I'm saying this. I'm not doing any shows in September. I need to step back and figure some stuff out, and I need a break. The last show I did in September was the 3rd or 4th of September. Within that time, I was able to sit and go over my finances. I have a business account where, and the start go over the finances, I realized, okay, in this business account, I am not able to differentiate or reflect where I have a payroll system, meaning say, if they say I make $10,000 for a show, $10,000 is not going through my account, because the manager, he accepts the $10,000 in his account and then pays me 70% of that. Remember, you know, the promoter, them are patient, you're 10 grand for your show, just saying a figure, right? But I don't, 10 grand now go through my account. 10 grand now pass through my account, me only reflect, say, $7,000, right? Because 20% of that is 2,000. 10% which goes to bookings is $1,000. So me would have get $7,000. Where is 7 would have come out, hair of the promoter, that makeup, clothing, everything. So I have to take care of my own expenses, of which I don't get paid till after the show is complete. So my money that I already have is what I would use to take care of my expenses beforehand, and I pay my own wages. Well, that said, when I go over the whole thing, I realize that, okay, when I do my taxes, I won't be able to show where I'm paying anybody anything. So I said to my manager, I said, can you do me a favor? Because I have shows that are outstanding that have not yet been completed. I have not, these shows are in the future, and I'm going to name them. So I can live on the same page with my dad, so I understand what I'm saying. There's a show, I have a show which I missed. I missed the other one yesterday, and there was one today for Heartburn. show was coming up, which was included up yesterday and today, and a few other shows up to the 23rd of February. Senator Richard said, Richie Flores, Rebelling CC, I said to him, Richie, in order for me to properly situate my finances and my business account and my taxes, I have to do taxes quarterly, right? I said to Richie, can you do me a favor, please? Forward the full balance of my deposits that are in your account to my business account. And when the shows are fulfilled, I will go ahead and oblige to my financial obligation, which would mean say I will pay you what is yours, and I will pay whoever is supposed to get their money. See it? And I also said that in a text message. Alright, this is a text message. So this is a text message. I said, hey Richie, you're probably asleep, but wanted to discuss deposits and where they should go regarding my account. With the graph we have, it shows that my business makes X amount for the year, but regarding my actual finances, it shows only a percentage, which complicates my taxes and other financial obligations. Can you please forward deposits to business account and starting account and payroll? And I would need to be, that would need to be done, please, and going further, call when you can. Also, when you can, please send me a summary report regarding... And I said, no problem. He said, no problem. I suggest we do a call on Monday to go through the spreadsheets and graphs, that there is more transparency and clarity as well.